Well, good evening and welcome to the Pelican Rapids High School 2023 Fall Concert. I always like to take this opportunity to welcome our 7th grade families and students to the high school band program. I always say this, but it's the first of over 100 performances we will do between now and the time that they graduate. If you think about that, think of all the anxiety and nerves you have getting up on stage and performing. For these kids to do that 100 times between now and when they graduate, think of that compared with students that don't get a chance to do that necessarily. And I just really think, you know, as far as just overcoming anxiety and getting up and performing, it's just such a great thing. So, yeah, welcome to the high school. It's a great thing here. We've got 19 seventh graders that are here up on stage. I'm their third band director in 3 years, so now they have me for the rest, so hopefully we get along all right, but I think it's good. Anyway, I'd just like to welcome you guys. I also would like to encourage you to stick around for the whole concert. We usually try to keep them just at about an hour, so we're not anything too long. So really for two reasons, though. Partly so the 7th graders and 8th and 9th graders can kind of hear what they sound like, what they're going to sound like in a year or two, you know, or three or five. And also so they can learn how to be audience members, because all of these kids will be taken to New York City and will be experiencing Broadway shows and some of the shows of the highest caliber with really sophisticated audiences. And so really what we have to do is we have to learn how to be good audience members. And that's actually, I always tell the kids, I think that's probably the harder part for them than even the performance part. So anyway, that's that. So welcome. Our next tune is called Foxborough March by John O'Reilly.
Thank you.
So a tempest is a violent storm, very often associated with swirling winds, stirring everything up into the air. So what Robert W. Smith does musically to create this effect is to feature melodies based on scales that kind of go up and down, and they make these sort of circular motions. So there's all this circular fashion stuff going on. Things begin to get more and more frantic as the musical ideas are added to the storm, and when the wind finally stirs everything up, you'll hear about 10 different things happening at the same time, and all the kids have to do their very best to try to keep it all together. This is Tempest by Robert W. Smith. Session again by John O'Reilly, and I think what he did with this piece, he didn't really write anything as far as notes to us, but what it sounds like to me is, you know how during the opening ceremonies of the Olympics, they have the Parade of Nations, where all the athletes from all the different countries come out, and I think that's kind of what he was depicting here. You'll hear the main processional theme, but in between statements of that theme, you'll hear things that sound very, very close to various national anthems. The one that really sticks out for me was the Canadian national anthem. You'll hear something that kind of sounds like it. And then some German national anthem type stuff, and then you'll even hear the Bugler's Dream theme, the dun, 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 something like that he just modified to make it his own so he wouldn't get caught stealing, I think. So, but anyway, this is Olympic Procession by John Riley.
Thank you.
second time's a charm, I guess, for the trumpets. Think about this now. In a normal band, there's going to be like at least 10 trumpets, right? 5 on the first part, 5 on the second. We have 2, 1 on the first part, 1 on the second. So the pressure on all of these bands, because our numbers are down a little bit right now, it just makes it really, really difficult. You can hear every single mistake, and it's so good for these kids to be able to play in these smaller ensembles. So even though it's our 7th graders, it's really good. It sounds really amazing. So the thing I want to tell you about is the fact that we'll be taking our yearbook picture after each group, so you can feel free to snap some pictures, but we will have a little pause. We have a photographer up there, hopefully. Okay, good. So right after this, we'll do our picture, and then after each band after that.
Thank you.
Alright, our next piece probably needs a little bit of explanation. It's called Night Cries, Real and Imagined. And what it really is an attempt to musically recreate fear of the dark. So much of what goes into fear of the dark is all in our head. Like when you feel somebody staring at you or something, when there's nobody around, or you feel somebody following you or watching you, or you know, things like that that happen in your brain. And that's kind of what he's getting after with this. The piece constantly changes with little or no repetition of the melodic material. So you're not going to be able to grab onto a tune like you did in that last one. It's just constantly changing, and it's kind of spooky. And basically, it just creates this sort of feeling of anticipation. And actually, the speed picks up about halfway through, and basically kind of creates this sort of running for your life type sound. So another anxiety-ridden tune here called Night Cries, Real and Imagined.
Thank you.
The next piece is basically about a castle, a Pevensey castle. So you hear some sort of medieval sounds and some castle-like sounds. The entire thing is in 3/4, so it can't really be any kind of a march type thing, but you can definitely hear them battling something. So the castle and some kind of a battle. This is Pevensey Castle. Next piece is called The Saber Dance. Probably one of the only ones you recognize. There's not a lot of familiar music to you guys. I apologize to that. We'll be doing some other fun stuff during our next concert, which you definitely will recognize. But anyway, this next one is called The Saber Dance and was written by Aram Khachaturian in 1942. And it really became a huge hit. It was part of a ballet that he wrote. And all the dancers were out there with these swords and doing all this fancy saber dancing type stuff. So this is The Saber Dance by Khachaturian. Thank you. Is called Un Decum, and it's basically Latin for 11th, which means 11th hour. And what happened was when Randall Stanbridge was writing music for one of his buddies that he went to high school with, actually, he always requested pieces at the last minute. So he literally said, "Hey, could you write a song for my spring concert?" And Randall Stanbridge said, "Sure, how long do I have?" He goes, 3 days. And Randall wrote that whole thing in 2 days, and he called it the 11th hour, and the whole thing was based on 11 eighth notes, so that's why you could hear the 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, all it adds up to 11, and it changes time signature like every single measure. Very difficult piece, but really, really cool. Again, just trying to create the energy of doing something at the last minute, the 11th hour. Totally different character now, Reflections by Kate Nishimura. She's an up-and-coming Canadian composer that really writes some really nice stuff. This is simply called Reflection, and it's just, you can do that. Just reflect on whatever you'd like while we play this.
Thank you.
Our next piece is called Simple Gifts, Four Shaker Songs by Frank Tekeli, and he says this about this piece. The Shakers were a religious sect who splintered from a Quaker community in the mid-1700s in Manchester, England. Known then derisively as Shaking Quakers because of the passionate shaking that would occur during the religious services, they were viewed as radicals, and their members were sometimes harassed and even imprisoned by the English. One of those imprisoned, Anne Lee, was named official leader of the church upon her release in 1772, and 2 years later, driven by her vision of a holy sanctuary in the New World, she led a small group of followers to the shores of America, where they founded a colony in rural New York. The Shakers were pacifists who kept a very low profile, and their membership increased only modestly during the decades following their arrival. At their peak in the 1830s, there were about 6,000 members in 19 communities interspersed between Maine and Kentucky. Soon after the Civil War, their membership declined dramatically. Their practice of intense simplicity and celibacy accounts for much of their decline. Well, it would, yes. The Shakers were known for their architecture, crafts, furniture, and perhaps most notably their songs. Shaker songs were traditionally sung in unison without instrumental accompaniment. Singing and dancing were vital components of Shaker worship in everyday life. Over 8,000 songs and some 800 songbooks were created, really by this small group of people. It's pretty amazing. Some of them during the 1830s and 1860s, most of them in between those two dates. The Frank Tekeli's arrangement for band here is built from four Shaker melodies. A sensuous nature song, a lively dance tune, a tender lullaby, and most famously, Simple Gifts, the hymn that celebrates the Shakers' love of simplicity and humility. In setting these songs, I sought subtle ways to preserve their simple, straightforward beauty. This is what Frank Tekeli writes. Melodic freshness and interest were achieved primarily through variations of harmony, of texture, and especially of orchestration. So what happens is he creates some new and constantly changing instrumental colors as the piece goes on these rather simple melodies in a rather difficult piece. So this is Simple Gifts, Four Shaker Songs by Frank Tekeli.
Thank you.
I've got one more for you. This is called Amparita Roca, and it's a very famous Spanish march written for band by Jaime Tejedor. And we'll conclude with this, and then we'll take our picture, and then we will see you guys in the spring, or in the winter, during our winter concert in February. So thanks for being a great audience, and we'll see you in February.